Well, hip-hop's anniversary is Friday. The culture that influenced everything from music to marketing took its first breath at a party in the Bronx 50 years ago.
Dan Charnas is the author of The Big Payback, The History of the Business of Hip-Hop. He's also a writer for The Wall Street Journal and recently wrote about the half-century celebration. He joins us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
I started hearing 50th anniversary of hip-hop and started doing the math, and I start thinking, wait a minute, Grandmaster Flash, was that 50 years ago? Like, what is the origin? It must predate Grandmaster Flash.
Well, it does, and it also predates that party, right? Why we celebrate that party on August 11, 1973 is that at that party, which was really just a house party that a girl named Cindy Campbell was throwing to raise money to get some school clothes, her brother Clive, aka Kool Herc, started playing only the sections of records that had just the drums or drums and bass, the breakdown sections of records, because he observed that dancers really liked those parts. So he created this technique called the merry-go-round, where he'd go from the break section of one record to the break section of another. And that we recognize as one of the core innovations of hip hop. But how you define hip hop, that really determines when hip hop actually starts. And there's some controversy about that.
Yeah, you also say that DJ Hollywood, Anthony Holloway, 5 years earlier had actually started what, the rhythms of this before that DJ?
In 1968, Anthony Holloway, DJ Hollywood, he started rapping to the beat, you know, rapping over the instrumentals, intros of disco records in Harlem. And by 1971, 1972, he was actually attracting a following in Harlem and in the Bronx. So if rapping over a beat is how we define hip hop, then it has to begin a little earlier than 73. On the other hand, you mentioned Flash, right?
Yeah.
And that's really important, because if we think about hip hop as when the DJ becomes a musician, Flash owns that. Flash was the first person, I believe, to really loop a beat as a bed for rappers or MCs to rap over. So I just feel like we need to, in this 50th year, we need to spread the credit around as much as we can.
Yeah, it was interesting, talking about Grandmaster Flash and how he knew electronics and came up with all these innovations and changing how record players turned or whatever it was. I was kind of surprised that you don't hear this argument back and forth at all. Grandmaster Flash seems kind of cool about it.
He is. He's been pretty subdued about it, but, you know, he's getting his flowers, at least around New York. You know, there was a big party up in the Bronx just a couple days ago. He was DJing. That card you're showing right there, that's also part of the controversy, because now that index card, which was supposedly, you know, promoting that August 11th party, is known now as a recreation, right? It's not the original card, if there actually was one. But listen, this is all a very hip-hop argument, right? You know, who gets the credit? Who had the skills? It's all part of why we celebrate this thing.
And the business of hip hop has just taken off. Talk about how it's evolved in the last 50 years.
Well, I mean, it went from, again, DJ Hollywood making $15 to, you know, rap into a microphone in the early 1970s to a multi-billion dollar business where you have Dr. Dre selling his consumer products company to Apple for something like $1 billion. Mm-hmm. Jay-Z doing joint ventures with Live Nation for his company, Roc Nation, consumer products, clothing, everything. And that's, hip hop has been incredibly adaptable and an incredible incubator for entrepreneurs.
Well, Dan's book is called The Big Payback, The History of the Business of Hip Hop. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Dan.